Hi everybody. In this video, I'm going to walk you through the second part of creating the holes practice type for my class. And in this particular video, we're going to concentrate on the counter bore. So what we're going to look at is the second hole in the series, the one that looks right here that has the counter bore surface at the top. Okay. You can see here in this section view that this is what it's going to look like. It's going to go all the way through the part. And right here are the dimensions that you need for my class in order to do this part successfully. So let's walk through what this actually means. First of all, we have a diameter symbol, and it says 0.375, 3/8 of an inch. What that tells us is the diameter of the shaft of the screw here would be 0.375 all the way across from here to here. Now, as far as there are two parts to every dimension for this screw, there would be how big is it diameter-wise, and then how far into the block does it actually go. And in this case, this goes all the way through. So we put the word through next to it. We have, in other words, one more time, a shaft that is 0.375 inches, 3/8 of an inch in diameter, and it goes all the way through the material. But on top of that, what we have is a counter bore. And so what we do is rather than separate this out, we put this all as one dimension, okay? So I hold down shift and enter, and it allows me to type a dimension on the second line like you've seen here in Fusion 360. And it says this. First of all, you see the symbol. It looks like a flat head as opposed to the countersink, which is over here, which is angled, okay? We have a counter bore, and we need to say how big the counter bore is diameter-wise. And we need to know how far do you actually drill into the material. So in this case, we have a diameter of 0.75. And that tells us from here all the way across to here is 0.75 or 3/4 of an inch. And then we have next to it the depth symbol. So it looks like an upside down arrow. Okay, that tells us how far down into the material are we going. And in this case, it's 1/4 inch. So from here down to the top of this right here is 0.25 inches. That's what all of this means. So we need to go create this then in Fusion 360. And if you want to come back or write these numbers down, it'd be a good idea. That way you don't have to keep constantly coming back, but I've got them memorized. Here we go. So this is what we stopped with last time. I want to be able to use that second hole now, that second point, to create a hole that has a counter bore. Unfortunately, those other points disappeared on me, right? Well, don't go redraw them. Please don't do that. Let's come up here. Let's expand our sketch menu, and let's click on the light bulb next to sketch 2. That makes it visible, and that means all the work features that we had here are now selectable, like this point. Okay, so I'm going to hit H for hole, and then I'm going to click on this point. Now, it defaults to all the things that I used in the last set to create this clearance hole, but I don't want to do that same thing here, so I'm going to change hole type from simple to counter bore. Okay, the depth of the hole is going to go all the way through, but the diameter of the hole is no longer 1/4 inch, it's 0.375. Okay, the tip angle we can leave alone. The counter bore depth is going to be 1/4 inch, so that's nice, defaults to that. But the counter bore diameter we know now is 0.75, 3/4 inch. Okay, so now we have all of those dimensions in place. We have the 0.375 for the shaft, we have the 0.75 diameter for the head of the counter bore, and we have a depth of 0.25 for the counter bore top right from here to here. Okay, so I'm going to come back. That looks all good. I'm going to say okay. And now you can see we have a counter bore that goes all the way through. Okay, now you'll notice that sketch 2 didn't go away now, and that's good because we actually want to keep going with the countersink in the next video. Okay, now anytime you want to hide that, you can just come over and click on the light bulb and that will go away. Okay, so there's the second video. We're going to leave those holes, these points up on sketch 2 so we can use those. In the next video, I'll walk you through how to actually go through and create the counter sink.